Following the F-35C Lightning II, P-8A Poseidon maritime surveillance aircraft, B-1B Lancer bomber, and F-A-18E-F Super Hornet. According to the most recent information, the F-15E Strike Eagle and F-15EX Eagle to fighter jets of the United States Air Force USAF would be used as launchers for the AGM-158C long-range anti-ship missile LRASM. In any high-level conflict in the Indo-Pacific, the U.S. Air Force will be able to strike enemy warships thanks to the Boeing F-15E and EX equipped with the AGM-158C LRASM. In order to incorporate the AGM-158C-1 missile type into F-15E and EX fighter jets, the U.S. Navy Naval Air Systems Command NAVAIR declared its intention to negotiate a contract with Lockheed Martin, the LRASM prime contractor. On the U.S. military side, the LRASM program is conducted by the U.S. Navy. The main LRASM subvariant currently in production is the AGM-158C-1. The AGM-158C-3, a longer-range variant of the missile that is presently in development, will also have enhancements and be able to fly almost twice as far, around 600 miles as opposed to 200 to 300 miles, depending on the information available. The F-15E and EX's anti-ship strike capabilities were dependent on the Harpoon anti-ship missile, which is not stealthy and has a significantly shorter range, before the AGM-158C was integrated. The preferred platform for the AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile JASSM cruise missile is already the U.S. Air Force's F-15E Strike Eagle. Additionally, the F-15EX has proven that it can use JASSM. The F-15E Strike Eagle and Eagle II can carry a lot of AGM-158Cs at once because of its enormous payload capacity. 5 JASSMs, which share the same exterior form factor as the LRASM, have previously been tested by the Air Force on a single F-15E. According to Lockheed Martin, the AGM-158C LRASM has a range of roughly 200 nautical miles, 370 kilometers, and a semi-autonomous guidance system. A 454 kilogram warhead can be launched by the missile at high subsonic speeds.